I can only do one thing. I've only done one thing my entire life, which is play the piano and write music. But Melinda had so many talents, as evidenced from this afternoon, painting, poetry, filmmaking, playwriting, journalism, and a keen interest in the interdisciplinary intersection of the arts. I think that that was her greatest love right there. She was also probably the greatest conversationalist that I've ever met. But I'd venture to say that her greatest talent was her insatiable curiosity. Like a child, she was always running towards something unknown or unexpected, always thrilled and excited, hoping to find some sort of an answer or a clue or something. Running, that's Melinda, and that's how I will always think of her. Constantly in motion, whether chasing an idea, a brushstroke, the perfect turn of phrase, a horse on the loose, or simply taking one of her long ruminative walks along the beach at Barcelona Point at Sag Harbor. I don't think any of us knew what she found on those long solitary walks, but I do know that whatever she learned from them is celebrated so much in her paintings and in her writings and in her life. I have to say I enjoyed and valued our post-meal chats in Sag Harbor, where Trevor would cook up a feast, and invariably we would wind up talking about what we were currently pursuing in our separate areas. Being a composer and a musician, I truly enjoyed our talks, thinking that at some point that we actually might get to the bottom of what we were actually discussing, but in fact we never did. But it didn't matter at all. The fun of it was the journey itself, the to be continued nature of our talks, and I couldn't wait until next week's installment. I felt bonded to Melinda in so many ways. We share a birth date, and she and Trevor share a birth year. She never ended up to that. But she and Trevor are both Brits and yet chose to live in America. Trevor and Melinda shared the love of horses, and we all shared a great love of the arts. What I missed the most, I think, is the intimacy that we all shared. Being able to speak to Melinda about a daily struggle, whether artistic or personal, and knowing that you were simply heard and taken in, and knowing that it would all be to be continued. I miss that every day. So let us all remember Melinda today and her incredibly original and eccentric spirit, and how lucky we all were to have been able to share some time with her for as long as this world allowed. Mm-hmm.